You hear that? I got myself some hash browns. Someone told me I say hash browns wrong. I put the stress on hash, but they said it's hash brown, and I don't know if there's really a difference, but if you think there's a difference, let me know and tell me which one's correct. A fried potato patty. I'm back to review some more harp scenes today. And let me tell you guys, I did a lot of research. Like, yeah, surprisingly, well, maybe not so surprisingly, it wasn't super easy to find a lot of films and shows with harps in it, or harpists, but I did my best. Some of them were really interesting, some of them were just plain wrong, so we're just gonna watch them today. That's better. We're gonna start going from the oldest to the most recent. The first movie that we're actually gonna start with is The Magic Christian. Funny thing is, it actually stars Ringo Starr, who is the drummer for the Beatles. He wasn't the original drummer, it was actually Pete Best. So his whole getup is hilarious to me. The little glasses lights. There's Ringo on the recorder. Okay, so the actor playing harp is straight up not playing at all. He's just kind of... It's a really beautiful harp though. As y'all know, I really love pretty harps.
Do you think words corrupt?
I don't know. Let's try. Agnes?
Yes?
Nipple. Well, there's no immediate physical change.
He's not playing at all. I like the coloring of the harp. It's kind of like black and this rustic gold. And his miming is pretty hilarious to me. Like this. It's not even close. But he tried. This is Annie, the 1982 version.
Annie!
I love her yellow dress. Okay, so I would say like her playing it isn't the worst, but what's really ruining it is that she's playing it on the wrong side. A harp leans over the right shoulder and not the left, and here she's got it over her left shoulder. It's just wrong. But who am I to judge? She straight up adopted a child. I didn't adopt a child. It seems like every single one is renting or borrowing a harp that has gold plating on it, which is... The next scenes we're gonna watch are from a movie called Valmont. And let me tell you, I spent 2 hours of my life watching this period piece with some whack-ass drama. Just appreciate the dedication that I had to making this video and to providing you this content. 2 hours, guys!
2 hours!
So in this scene, Cecil is having her harp lesson, and that's her harp teacher. You'll notice that this harp looks different than the other harps that we've seen so far, and that's because this is a lever harp. It has a little lever at the top of each string, and you can manually lift it, and then it will raise the string a half step, which will raise the pitch. A pedal harp has pedals all across the bottom of the bass. It helps rotate these smaller discs that are attached at the top of the harp, and they will rotate like this, and they will help press against the string with these little nubs. These little nubs will press against the string and you can raise it a half step and then a whole step. There is a lot more technically that you can do with a pedal harp, which is why professional harpists or classical harpists will play pedal harps instead of lever harps. The repertoire for a lever harp is a little bit more limited than what you could play on a pedal harp. Looks like he's playing too. I'm convinced she's actually playing as well because what I'm hearing and what she's doing with her fingers definitely looks accurate. And she's singing too, which is super impressive. I have tried to sing and play the harp at the same time, and this is what came out of it.
Rack city bitch, rack, rack city bitch. Rack city bitch, rack, rack city bitch.
In this scene, we find out that they've been exchanging letters to each other. They're not supposed to because she's got a man. This scene again definitely looks like she's playing. It looks like she had lessons. Her form isn't all there, but she's doing a good job. A very good job.
Your rhythm's quavering a bit.
I don't like a man who's critical. Can we talk about this harp cover? It's like a blue silk. So nice. Ooh, boy, you're in trouble. If you know the harp, there is literally a storage in the harp. Why would you put it in the strings? Like, be smarter. There's a little hole in the harp. It's hollow. Just I apologize for the lighting change. I lost this clip, so now I'm refilming it. It'll still be good.
Trust means more to me than all your anger. Goodbye.
Ooh. Oh my gosh, sir, why are you manhandling it? Oh my gosh. Sir, you're embarrassing yourself. Pick up your things and go. My god, sir, just put down the harp. Looking like a fool. The Drew Carey Show, there was a particular episode where his boss moves in with a harp, and this is definitely gold. Gold. So he's definitely not playing it. That position is so wrong. At least he's sitting on the right side of the harp, though. Everybody she sees who's reaching out to capture a moment. Everyone knows it's windy. He's doing a good job, but his hand position is not correct. Beautiful harp again. Look at that crown. What a queen. This is the Matrix. This is the restaurant scene where Cypher is negotiating a deal with one of the agents.
After 9 years, you know what I realize? Ignorance is bliss.
Let me tell you why this is such an interesting scene for me. It's because that motion of the harpist kind of gliding her finger over the strings. It's called a glissando, or a gliss for short. And so when Cypher says
ignorance is bliss,
she plays a gliss. I think that a harp also kind of makes you envision or imagine sort of a really idyllic, peaceful place, and this really helps drive that point forward as he's saying ignorance is bliss. 10 out of 10, excellent use of harp in this film. Okay, the next movie that we have on the list is The Princess Diaries 2. I just love the garden party aesthetic. Look at all the hats, like the decorations. Oh, look at that harp, it's gold. Anne Hathaway looks stunning too, but that harpist is definitely playing, and I love the whole setup. It's so beautiful. The vocalist is doing a great job as well. And not much to say. Real harpist, real music, and like that is the ideal place to be playing a harp in. I can't imagine a better setting for it. Next scene that we have is actually in Harry Potter. A fun little fact about me is that I've never read the Harry Potter series. And I'm pretty sure I don't remember any of the Harry Potter movie because I never fully watched it. Please don't come after me. I know I'm a Hufflepuff, whatever that means, but that's about the extent of my knowledge. In this particular scene, Harry, Hermione, and I think Ron go to the three-headed dog, and the harp has put the dog to sleep and it's playing itself. Thing is, I just like don't listen to harp music that much, which sounds blasphemous. As a harpist, I always forget just how good it sounds.
He's snoring. Snape's already been here. He's put a spell on the harp.
Concert brand, gorgeous ornamentation on the column. Not much to say other than I think a self-playing harp would be pretty cool, but that would put us out of jobs. This next scene is from Drake and Josh. Josh is trying to impress Mindy's parents by putting together a really fancy dinner for them.
Josh, this is quite an impressive dinner.
Someone hired a harpist.
Food, for a nice sculpture, the elderly harpist.
Why is it always an elderly harpist? It's so unprofessional to fall asleep at the harp. Josh really just pitched that bread at her. If you're gonna eat bread at me, I ask that you use gluten-free bread. Gold heart. I'm obsessed with the gold.
I told you that this was my last chance to impress Mindy's parents. I spent like 2 days working on this dinner, Josh. And I spent like $300 on a dumb harpist who at this point should stop playing.
If you're gonna pick pay $300 for Harpist Josh, like, at least let her keep playing, because you probably booked her for like 1.5 to 2 hours. Get your money's worth, man. The next clip we're gonna watch is from How I Met Your Mother. It's Lily and Marshall's wedding day.
Wow, Andrea, you really are pregnant.
Yeah.
How do you play the harp with your belly so?
Oh, I don't really. I can only reach about half the string.
You only play half the harp?
Yeah.
Okay, Lily, I will take care of this.
To be honest, I don't know how difficult it is to actually play the harp while you're pregnant. I'd imagine that it just feels a little bit more inconvenient, right? Because you kind of have like an extra person with you. I think you could get away with it. Also, another gold harp. So she's definitely not playing, the audio is not matching up, but also she's on the wrong side of the harp too, so if you're not gonna do anything else right, just sit on the right side. Well, the next few clips are going to be from The Big Bang Theory. Mayim Bialik is the actress for Amy. She actually did learn how to play the harp specifically for these scenes, and she took lessons with, I think, Sylvia Woods, one of the Sylvia Woods teachers. She did want to look like she actually knew how to play the harp, but the great thing about Mayim is that she is a musician already. She knows how to play the piano, the bass guitar, and the trumpet as well, so this wasn't super difficult for her to pick up. The very first song she learned to play was Girl from Ipanema, which is a bossa nova standard. I think jazz is a little bit difficult to play in the harp, so her teacher really did have to kind of work to arrange something that was simpler to play and that she could sing along with.
5, 6, 7, 8, tall and tan and young and lovely, the girl from Ipanema goes walking, and when she passes, each one she passes goes,
Amy, Amy.
Mayim only had 2 weeks to learn this. I think that's really impressive for someone to go from the basics, like not knowing how to play harp at all, and then within 2 weeks' time be able to perform this live and in front of an audience. So I guess they really enjoyed having her play the harp, so they had her play more harp music in this season. In this scene, she plays Everybody Hurts.
Everybody hurts. Sometimes.
If you've never played the harp while you were sad, you're not doing it right.
Sometimes.
So the little knock that she did on the soundboard is actually an extended technique. And extended techniques are what happens when you use like an instrument or even voice in an unconventional or unorthodox way to produce a different kind of sound or a different kind of timbre. So the harp has a couple of different things you can do. You can knock on the soundboard, you can tap on the soundboard, you can also do this thing with the this thing, and you can also take a screwdriver to the strings. You can also do gongs, you can do sliding, which makes kind of like a whistling sound. And so in this last one, she plays Wanted Dead or Alive.
I'm a cowboy on a steel horse I ride. I'm
I love it, all the scenes. They're pretty simple, the songs that she's playing, the arrangements that she has, but they're super impressive again. 10 out of 10, she did a great job. The very last scene I got is from the Netflix show Love is Blind, where they find love. If you haven't seen Love is Blind, don't watch this because this is a spoiler. A harp appears for Lauren and Cameron's wedding. From what I've read, Netflix did supply some of the basic things for the weddings, but past that, the couples had to themselves fund certain parts of their weddings for anything extra. Theirs was the only wedding to have a harp. Also, Lauren and Cameron are definitely my favorite couple out of this entire show. Kenny also has a place in my heart. As we bring Lauren out walks beautiful bride. In, you know, you see the harpist playing and gorgeous harp. Gorgeous wedding. I'm convinced she's actually playing it because I don't know why they would hire a harpist that didn't know how to play. Even though I can't really tell from the shots, I do think she's playing. Okay, cool. What have I learned today? What have we learned today? Well, I learned that I've got a thing for luxury. Who doesn't like gold? Thank you for going on this journey with me. Watching all of these harp scenes from all these movies and films. I really enjoyed it. I really enjoyed our time together. And I hope you found this entertaining in some way. Do you see me?
Yes.
Okay. I've spent the last few days editing, so I'm gonna go take a really long nap.